everyone. I hear that your theme this week is compassion. I love this theme. It means a lot to me. One of my favourite parts of the Bible is when Jesus is described as looking upon the crowds who are harassed and needy. And it says, he looked upon the crowds and he had compassion upon them. Compassion is a really fundamental part of the Christian faith. And I think it's a fundamental part of being human. Compassion simply is a concern for the suffering of others. It's a concern for the suffering of others. And we can have compassion for others, but also it's important to have compassion for ourselves as well. I thought we could look at compassion and break it down into three areas. The first one is seeing, the second is feeling, and the third is acting. So let's start with seeing. In order to have concern for the suffering of others, we have to understand what that suffering looks like. We can do that in a number of ways. We can ask people how they're doing, especially in relationship. We can listen to people when they're suffering. We can ask them, and then it's really important to listen to what they say in order to really understand and to see where they're coming from. It might be small things like just being really tired with work, or your parents might be quite tired, and actually understanding and having compassion enables us to then be able to act with compassion. It might be that your friends are going through something, and again, investigating what that is, trying to find out what their suffering looks like, is really important. On bigger issues, to have compassion for bigger things in the world, you might have recently heard a lot about the Black Lives Matter, about the different parts of the world that are suffering in different ways with COVID. In order to have compassion for these issues and concern for the suffering of others in different countries that are further away from our experience, I think we need to be able to find out more about them. And there's a number of different ways we can do this. I used to think that I couldn't really understand the news. I'm very artistic, and I used to think that I wasn't really bright enough to understand the news, but really I was really missing out. And I would really encourage you guys to watch the news. There's quite a few good young people's news programmes. So there's News Round. There's this one on YouTube. It's called BBC What's New. I'd really encourage you to look at that. And then there's this other one. It's from Sky. And it's called live.firstnews.co.uk. And the one from Sky, I watched a little bit of it the other day, and it was really breaking down the whole understanding of Black Lives Matter. But not only was it telling us what's happening right now with the protests and the really sad death of tragic death of George Floyd, but it was also showing the whole story. So they went back through the history of slavery, of why these things are now so painful for so many people. And I think that's one way of for us to see the suffering, is to actually engage with these programs, engage with one another in a really authentic way. And don't let yourself think that you're too young to engage with these issues. I wasted a lot of my life thinking I wasn't bright enough because I'm dyslexic, but actually we all have a heart, and we all have a brain, and we all have a mind, and we all have a deep ability to have compassion. So I would really encourage you, learn from my mistakes, and don't let yourself be put off from watching these news programmes. The second area I would say is feeling. Feelings are really important, and we shouldn't be scared of them. Once we have seen these areas of suffering, whether it's in our friends' lives, in our families' lives, in our siblings' lives, or whether it's on a broader scale, and it's in different countries, it will probably bring up for us some feelings, probably feelings of sadness. You'll see in this picture there's lots of different words and all interlinked. And I think often feelings can feel like that. There's a lot of them and they can feel confusing. But I wouldn't be afraid of feelings. They're what makes us human, and they're actually what makes us strong. They're what links us to one another. And then finally, after we've seen suffering and after we've had the courage to allow ourselves to feel, is finally the position we're in is to act with compassion. So once we've seen and we've felt, the final stage is to act. And these actions, they may be really small actions of compassion, but I'm sure they will mean a lot, especially on a personal level, within your family and within your friends. These little actions of compassion that come from seeing suffering and from feeling it will mean a lot to whoever receives them. It may be just helping someone out with their chores. It may be saying something kind. It may be spending a tiny bit of your pocket money on something for someone when you know they're suffering. On a larger scale, it may be engaging, even though you're young, you have a voice and you have a mind and you have a heart, and it may be using that voice and that mind and that heart to engage in the political arena where you feel that there is injustice, where you feel there's suffering. Your action of compassion may be that you sign a petition. If you feel that you see suffering and there's a petition going around that warrants a signature, I would encourage you to do that. It may be you've seen, probably on the news, to engage in peaceful protests with your parents if they're doing that. But I would say that my one thing I would say is that we have to hold on. When we act in compassion, we have to remember that we are motivated to relieve the suffering of others. I think that's, whenever we act and we act in compassion, that's the thing that we have to hold on to, that our motivation is always to relieve the suffering of others. And that can be in very small things, it can be in bigger things. But that's the one thing that makes it so different, that makes that action so different. So as we close, if we reflect on those three things, in ways in which in our lives we can see suffering, we can open our eyes, educate ourselves, we can feel the suffering of others, and then we can act. And as we close, I'd just love us to remember that and take comfort in the fact that God sees our suffering and sees the suffering of the world. Not only does he see it, but he feels pain over the suffering of us and the suffering of the world. And finally, even though we can't see it in many ways, that he is acting with us, that he is strengthening those that are acting to rid and break the suffering of others. But he's also acting on behalf of us, acting to rid us of our suffering. So as we close, if we could bow our heads in prayer or in just a time of reflection, whatever you're most comfortable with, I'm just going to say a little prayer. Dear Lord, I thank you that you looked upon the crowds that were suffering and you had deep compassion. Lord, release that compassion in each one of us today. Enable us to see more clearly, to feel more deeply, and to act with more wisdom and depth, Lord. Give us your strength and your heart for one another and for your world. And Lord, give us the comfort to know that you are with us, that you see our suffering and the suffering of the world, that you feel our suffering and the suffering of the world, and that you are acting on our behalf and on the behalf of the world to bring justice and peace. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.